viewers, here we will discuss about the wake turbulence. Wake turbulence is a disturbance in the atmosphere that forms behind an aircraft as it passes through the air. All aircraft generates wake vortices, which are known as wake turbulence. These are strong rotating air masses behind the wingtips of the aircraft. Thus, wake turbulence is a byproduct of lift. Low pressure on top of the wing and a relatively high pressure on the bottom produced lift. The air mass leaves at the wingtip. The higher pressure on the bottom goes around the tip and gets drawn into the lower pressure on the top of the wing. These small vortices mix together and roll up behind the aircraft into two main vortices, turning in opposite directions, clockwise behind left wing and anti-clockwise behind the right wing. This vortex causes the drag that is induced by the lift. The greater the pressure differential between the top and bottom of the wing, the greater will be the induced drag and the stronger the vortex. Wake vortex generation begins when the nose wheel lifts off the runway on takeoff and continue until the nose wheel touches down on landing. Wake vortex generation is related with aircraft gross mass, airspeed, configuration, and wingspan. Vortex strength increases proportionally to weight. It is greatest for heavy aircraft when heavy aircraft is flying in clean configuration or is flying slowly. As an aircraft slows while maintaining altitude, the wings have to produce the same amount of lift at that lower speed. To create that lift at the lower speed, the wings will have to work harder by increasing angle of attack. So, lift causes induced drag, and that induced drag causes the wingtip vortex, and that the strength of the vortex increases as the aircraft slows. The active part of vortex has a very small radius of few meters only, but there is a lot of energy due to the high rotation speed of the air. Decent rate of wake vortex in calm air during cruise phases 300 to 500 feet per minute and during approach phases 700 feet per minute. In calm air, vortex descends slowly. When aircraft is close to ground at a distance less than a wingspan length, the two vortices tend to drift out from the center line at a speed of 2 to 3 knots. This is how, with time, they decay or fade out in calm wind conditions. A crosswind will decrease the lateral movement of the upwind vortex and increase the movement of the downwind vortex. Light crosswind could result in the upwind vortex remaining in the touchdown zone for a period of time. This will affect next movement on same runway. And light crosswind could also result in fast drift of the downwind vortex away from the runway, but in this case, it can affect the parallel runway operations. Tailwind condition can move the vortices of the preceding aircraft forward into the final approach and touchdown zone. Special attention needs to be given to situations of light crosswind or tailwind where vortices may remain for a considerable time in the approach and runway touchdown zone area, or it can drift to a parallel runway or sink to the landing or takeoff path of succeeding aircraft. Helicopter also generates wake vortices. A hovering or slow hovering taxiing helicopter generates a downwash from main rotor. The downwash can contain high wind speeds within 3 rotor diameter of the helicopter. When rotor downwash contacts the surface, the resulting outwash vortices have behavioral characteristics which are similar to wingtip vortices of fixed wing aircraft. The vortex circulation is outward, upward, around, and away from the main rotor in all directions. Pilots of small aircraft should avoid operating within 3 rotor diameters of any helicopter that is in a slow hover taxi or stationary hover. 3 basic effects of wake turbulence on the following aircraft are induced roll, loss of height or rate of climb, or possible structural stress. The effect of wake turbulence is maximum in approach path because the following aircraft is in critical state with regard to speed, thrust, altitude, and reaction time. Wake turbulence encounters have been classified according to the reported roll angle. Severe, a reported roll angle in excess of 30 degrees. Moderate, a reported roll angle of 10 to 30 degrees. Light, a reported roll angle of less than 10 degrees. Wake turbulence category of aircraft are based on maximum takeoff weight. As per ICAO, they are 4 wake turbulence categories: super, heavy, medium, and light. Provisions of air traffic service. For aircraft in the heavy wake turbulence category, the word heavy shall be included immediately after the aircraft call sign in the initial radio telephony contact between such aircraft and air traffic service unit. The ICAO wake turbulence category is entered in the appropriate single character wake turbulence category indicator in item 9 of the ICAO model flight plan form. ATC is not providing wake turbulence separation, such as when a VFR aircraft is landing behind a large aircraft or following aircraft is executing an visual approach. The ATC unit, when deemed necessary, issue a caution of possible wake turbulence. Caution, wake turbulence from arriving, Boeing 744. Action by pilot. Aircraft shall be operated at or above the flight path of the large preceding aircraft or changing course as necessary to avoid the area behind and below the large aircraft, which is generating wake turbulence. Pilot in command shall adhere to the manufacturer guidelines for wake encounter. The wake turbulence is produced as the side effect of lift generated on aircraft and constrains the separation minimum between leading and trailing aircraft during approach and departure phases. The trailing aircraft must be separated with the predefined distance or time from the leading aircraft to avoid potential hazards of wake turbulence effect. The separation minimum are defined based upon the aircraft weight categorization. This table is used for applying time-based wake turbulence separation between arrivals. Suppose, if light aircraft is arriving behind a heavy aircraft, we need 3 minutes of wake turbulence separation. Wake turbulence separation is applied between departure aircraft when the departure aircraft are using same runway, parallel runways which are separated by less than 760 meters, crossing runways or parallel runways which are separated by 760 meters or more if the projected flight path of second aircraft will cross the projected flight path of the first aircraft at the same altitude or less than 1000 feet below. This table is used for applying time-based wake turbulence separation between departures using full length. Suppose if light aircraft is departing behind a heavy aircraft, we need 2 minutes of wake turbulence separation. This table is used for applying time-based wake turbulence separation between departures using intermediate runway length. Suppose if the light aircraft is departing behind a heavy aircraft, we need 3 minutes of wake turbulence separation. This table is used for applying time-based wake turbulence separation between arrival and departure in case of displaced threshold or opposite runway departure. Table shows the wake turbulence separation applied to all aircraft in all phases of flight while under radar control. These distances apply when one aircraft is operating directly behind another or is crossing behind at the same level and up to 1,000 feet below. Vortices generally dissipate or break up in one of the three ways. First, over a long period of time, turbulent diffusion can enlarge each wake so that the wakes merge and dissipate. Second, disturbances along the length of vortices became unstable and sinusoidal oscillations developed, which caused the vortices to touch and link together. Third, a sudden structural change known as vortex breakdown or bursting can abruptly widen the vortex core. Winglets or sharklets are upward or downward curved extension at the wingtips. Winglets reduce the induced drag caused by lift, thus minimizing wake turbulence. The vortices that cause wake turbulence may be invisible, but they can kill you just as quickly as thunderstorm that you can see. Maintain wake turbulence situational awareness. Avoid the area below and behind the wake-generating aircraft, especially at low altitude.
Thank you.